All right, so again, welcome to this review session for review on basic accounting, review on sole proprietorship, actually. So review on sole proprietorship, and we are going to start with review on basic accounting. So part one muna tayo, guys. Please, tawag noon patience kasi we have to start with theories. Alam ko na kating-kati kayo na mag-solve ng problems. Alam ko yan. Pero needed kasi ang theories kasi hindi lang naman problem solving ang bibigay sa inyo in the future aside from quali. Meron ding yung mga theoretical questions. Of course, meron ding theories sa quali. Okay? And the only portion of the quali na merong multiple choice ay yung theories. Tapos, the rest of the problem, the rest of the exam, puro yan computation. Malala pa sa quali, papaggawin kayo ng mga financial statements or gagawa kayo ng mga worksheets. I mean, working papers. Merong portion ng test paper na ipoprovide as solution part. So hindi na kayo gagawa ng hindi na kayo magdadala ng tawag noon. Hindi na kayo magdadala ng columnar la na yun. Okay? Anyway, so let's start with item number 1. Okay? So theoretical questions part 1 letter A. Accounting process. Okay? So, accounting process. Actually, majority dito, mga accounting process lang naman ito eh. Right? So, let us have statement 1. Okay? So, read carefully yung statement. By the way, merong nagtatanong sa akin on the tips answering for theory questions kasi doon daw sila mahina or hindi sila parang confident in answering for theory questions. Yung advice ko, guys, is keep on reading. Guys, keep on reading. Mali kasi, guys, yung scenario, although na naranasan ko na somewhat medyo nagigets ko yung problem solving, pero pag dadating sa theories, hindi na ako nakakapagsagot. Merong mga ganyan, guys, sa scenario. Or minsan naman, okay ka sa theories, pero tagilid ka sa problem solving. Pero normal lang yan, guys. Normal lang yan. It takes practice and time for you to conjive yung dalawang yun. Mahirap, pero little by little, kaya natin. For theories, again, yung ano ko dyan is keep on reading. Minimize na muna yung mga social media. Okay? Although guilty ako dyan sa social media na yan dati. Pero of course, we have to make sacrifice. Keep on reading. Then, upon reading something, huwag kalimutan na i-apply ang concept ng nabasa mo on the problem solving. Kasi habang nagsosolve ka, kinokonnect mo siya sa concept, doon mo ma-realize na maingay mag-study ang accountancy students. Maliban lang sa calcu. Merong iba, matahimik, pero seldom lang. Pero talaga pag nag-study ka, okay, hindi ka pwede sa library ng ganyan. Okay? Okay. So, yun ha. Yun yung tip. Keep on reading. Then, after reading, apply immediately. Hindi pwedeng basahin mo, then after 1 week ka mag-a-apply ng concept. Hindi ganun. Walang retention yan eh. Like, for example, sa statement 1, sabi dito, okay, review to ha. This is just a review of what you have learned in basic accounting. So, ang sabi dyan, statement 1. Statement 1. The accounting process, okay? The accounting process, or commonly known as accounting cycle, is a series of procedures involving collection, processing, communication, and communication of financial information. And as per definition, accounting involves the recording, classifying, summarizing, and interpreting financial information. Okay, so by that first statement is defining the accounting process and as well as what is accounting. So, based on your understanding and based on what you remember dun sa basic accounting nyo, what is your judgment dun sa statement 1? Okay? Hindi ko naman sinasabi na ganito ang format ng theory sa quali nyo. It may, pero it's a little chance but still a chance na magiging ano, pwede sa quali. Kung ako gagawa ng quali nyo, ganitong paborito ko, statement 1, statement 2. Okay? Pero on your ano, on your understanding, ano yung ano natin? Ano yung verdict? How do we analyze statement 1? Is it correct or incorrect? Dalawa lang naman. Correct or incorrect maging verdict natin. Hindi true or false. Okay? Wag true or false. Bakit hindi true or false? Sa choices, walang true or false. Okay? Correct, incorrect. Ano yung sagot natin, guys? Kung nagkapag-advanced reading tayo. I mean, nakapag-advanced answer. Kasi, pag nandun ka na sa exam, tapos nagbabasa ka na, you are trying to answer a question, the skill or the technique that you need to do is to have key points. Key points, key terms, ganyan. In order for you to properly assess kung tama ang statement. Okay? So, balikan natin yung statement 1. Okay? Ano ulit ang sabi? The accounting process or commonly known as accounting cycle or pwedeng vice versa, it is a series of procedures involving collection, processing, and communication of financial information. And as per definition, okay, accounting involves the recording, classifying, summarizing, and interpreting financial information. Correct or incorrect? Okay. So, correct. Okay, correct. Wow. Ang sama naman. Wait lang guys ha. May naglabas ng notif. Sabi dito, your call ends in 10 minutes. One more time. Oh my gosh. So, hindi talaga pwedeng ma-extend. Okay. So, guys, ipopost ko muna ang recording. Okay. So, balik tayo. Statement 1. Okay? So, sa statement 1, that is correct. The statement 1 is correct. Okay? So, yun yung judgment natin o yung ating verdict for statement 1. So, the accounting process or commonly known as accounting cycle or yung vice versa is a series of procedures involving collection, processing, and communication of financial information. So that's the first definition referring to the accounting process. So based on what we understand with accounting cycle, it is really a process that involves several steps. Those several steps, kung sa-summarize natin yung several steps na yon, so that would be that for number 1, okay? Ay. Number 1, accounting cycle. So, accounting cycle is a series of steps in. Series of steps in collecting. And collecting processing, and communicating financial information by way of presenting them through what? Financial statements. Okay? So, yan. So, yung first statement, okay? So, statement 1 is correct. Okay? Correct. Next, what about statement 2? Sabi sa statement 2, financial information is presented in reports. Okay? Financial information is presented in reports called financial statements. However, before they can be prepared and presented in such manner, accountants need to gather information about an entity's business transactions, record and collate them to come up with amounts or values to be presented as part of financial reports. Then additionally, however, only accountable business transactions or events can be entered in the records. So, how do we assess statement 2? Ano assessment natin for statement 2, people? Correct or incorrect? Okay, so read carefully again. Financial information is presented in reports called financial statements. So in that sentence, kasi parang medyo small paragraph yung statement 2 eh. So yung first sentence na yan is actually correct. So financial information is presented in reports called financial statements. So in connection with our statement 1, when we gather financial information, we process them, record them, classify them, then collate them, then communicate finally in reports called financial statements. So sa sentence na yan, correct na yan. Okay? Tapos may sumunod na statement or sentence, sabi niya, however, before they can be prepared and presented in such a manner, accountants need to gather information about an entity's business transactions. Okay. Ano yung portion dito na we can relate with statement 1? Yung sinasabi dito na record and collate them to come up with amounts or values to be presented as part of financial reports. Okay. Sa statement 1, may nakalagay doon, collection, processing, communication of financial information. Okay. So, related yan. Actually, iniba lang yung terms but they are just the same. Okay? Second sentence, yung however something dyan, is also correct because that's another way of defining the accounting process and the accounting itself. Yung titignan nyo na lang guys is the last sentence. Ang sabi dyan, okay, if the last sentence, yung sabi dito, additionally, however, only accountable business transactions or events can be entered in the records. Kung hindi sana yan nandyan, guys, correct na sana statement 2 yung ating magiging verdict. Pero wala pa naman tayo, guys, sa verdict eh. Wala pa tayong assessment kung correct siya or hindi. We still have to assess the last sentence. Sabi dyan, however, only accountable business transactions or events can be entered in the records. Yung clue term natin dyan, guys, yung tawag is accountable. Okay? Accountable, tapos nasa huling part, sabi dyan, can be entered in the records. So, by that information that you have read, ano ang ating assessment with the entire statement 2? Correct or incorrect? Alright. Okay? So, for the sentence number 3 ng statement 2, that is actually correct. Okay? So, both statements are correct. Take note guys, when we are considering accounting, okay, when we say accounting, yung kinoconsider lang natin people for for accounting is to accounting is for recording ano yun? Recording, classifying, summarizing, and interpreting data or information extracted from what? Accountable. Accountable. Business transactions. Okay, business transactions or events. Okay? So, for statement 2, statement 2, assessment natin is correct. So, for number 1, sagot natin is letter A. Okay? Nasundan ako for number 1.
Yes, sir.
Yun. Okay? So, take note that for accounting, only accountable business transactions ang pwedeng i-enter natin sa records. Although there are several transactions then that will involve the entity, okay? But, take note, not all transactions or events can be considered accountable. So later on in the succeeding items, pwede nating i-consider kung ano yung mga accountable events or at saka yung ano yung hindi accountable events. Okay, how can we say if an item is accountable or how can we say if an item is not accountable? Okay? So okay na ako for statement 1. Sagot natin for statement 1 is letter A. Okay? Both statements are correct. Loading. Nag-loading. Oh, yan. Next. For statement 2. Okay, for statement 2. Oh, statement 2? For number 2 rather. Okay, number 2, anong sabi dyan? Statement 1, for number 2, statement 1, a business transaction or event is considered accountable when it affects the entity's assets, liabilities, and equity, including revenues and expenses. Say guys. Correct, incorrect. All right. Correct. Why correct? Okay? Yung consideration natin for accountable events or business transaction. So for an event or transaction be considered as accountable, it must affect the elements of financial statements. So, ano-ano yung mga elements ng financial statements na yan? Yung minention natin kanina. Okay? Minention natin kanina. Yung assets, liabilities, equity, income, and expense. Okay? income and expenses. Hindi naman ibig sabihin, it doesn't mean guys na in a transaction kailangan lahat sila maapektuhan. It could be, okay? It could be, pero hindi ko sabihin talaga na merong ganyang transaction na isang transaction apektuhan lahat. Okay, naapektuhan lahat. There are certain transactions na pwede maapektuhan lahat ng elements ng financial statements in just one transaction, pero very rare 'yan. Okay? At least lang naman guys, at least one or two. Okay? One or two or kahit saan doon sa elements ng financial statements, assets, liabilities, equity, tsaka yung income and expenses. Maapektuhan lang by the business transaction or event, accountable na po yung event na yun. That means, pag naging accountable siya, pwede natin siyang, yung amounts na makukolekta natin, ma-extract natin, okay? Or, when we say accountable, the event can be measured, so pwede na siyang ma-enter sa ating records or sa accounting system. Okay? Nahabol ako dun, guys, sa statement 1. All right. So next, let us have with statement 2. So sabi dyan sa statement 2, the accounting process is a continuous cycle. Take note ha. The accounting process is a continuous cycle and does not end with the preparation of financial statements. Okay, sabi pa, several steps are needed to be done before the accounting system became ready for the next reporting period. Okay, an accounting cycle only ends upon the termination of an entity's operation. So, how do we assess statement 2? Is it correct or incorrect? Read carefully. Ulit ha, sabi dyan, accounting process is a continuous cycle and does not end with the preparation of financial statements for the current period. Okay? Okay, so let's start assessing each sentence in the statement 2. Yung first statement na binasa ko pa lang, that is correct. Why correct? Kasi nga, dun sa statement 1 pa lang ng item 1, accounting cycle, accounting process. So, process is a continuous cycle. So, when an entity is operating, it does not mean na pag meron siyang accounting process, for the period lang yan. Continuous yan, guys. And, take note, there are several steps. Tapos, sabi niya dyan, does not end with the preparation of financial statements. If you have remembered yung basic accounting nyo, pang ilang step kaya yung preparation of financial statements? Okay? So, ano lang muna yan? Stay put lang muna yung tanong na yan. Huwag muna nating sagutin in advance. Pero, itatanong ko sa inyo in advance, pang ilang step yung paggawa ng financial statement? Okay? So statement 1 sentence 1 of statement 2 is correct. Next, several steps, yung clue natin dito is yung term na several steps. Okay, several steps are needed to be done before the accounting system become ready for the next reporting period. So ibig sabihin, pag natapos ang reporting period natin, current reporting period, okay? Mayroon pang mga steps na gagawin natin in order for yung system natin or yung pag-record for the next reporting period maging ready. Okay? So meaning dun sa accounting process, yung mga several steps na yun, meron dong tinutukoy na several steps. Kung ano yun, hindi pa natin alam. Kasi nga, that's an advance for the next item. Okay? So yan. So, several steps are needed to be done before the accounting system become ready for the next reporting period. Hindi kasi pwede guys na pag natapos ka ngayon, you're going to use immediately the accounting system for the next reporting period. Hindi pwede. Although, yung idea is continuous talaga yung paggamit ng accounting system due to accounting cycle. Okay? But the fact na immediately hindi pwede, we still have to do several steps. So, second sentence of statement 2 is also correct. Yung term ha, before the accounting system became ready. Okay, became ready or become ready. Then last, ito yung last. An accounting cycle only ends upon the total termination of, sorry, total termination of an entity's operation. So by that, how do we assess statement 2? Correct or incorrect? Guys, correct or incorrect? Guys, believe it or not, when I was still in undergrad, ganito yung inadapt kong technique. Reading, apply the readings, tapos I am pointing out key points in order for me to assess kung tama ang statement or yung question. Okay? So, okay na tayo sa first sentences, first two sentences ng statement 2. Yung last na lang, yun yung magiging last, ano natin, assessment to consider yung statement 2 kung correct siya or hindi. Oh, ano? Correct or incorrect? An accounting cycle only ends upon the total termination of the entity's operation. Sabi niya dito, an accounting cycle only ends upon what? Total termination. Total termination of what? Entity's operation. Correct, incorrect. Oh, yun. Correct. Bakit correct, guys? By the term itself, accounting cycle, dapat continuous. Kasi nga cycle eh. But, magiging continuous lang siya if the entity's operation is also continuous. Kung magto-total termination ng isang entity for its operation, hindi na siya magiging continuous, guys. So, tama lang na accounting cycle will end upon total termination ng operation. Uy, Mr. Maseda, wag mo akong tanongin kung correct. Question mark ka pa talaga, galing mo. Anyway, so correct yung ano natin, ha? Correct. So statement. Statement 2. Statement 2. Correct. So sagot natin is letter A. Yan. Sana yun. Okay, take note. Sagot natin, letter A. Both statements are correct. Okay na. O, sige. Number 3. Waray audio? Wait guys ha, kay...
Wait guys ha, kay...
Wait, ano
wait,
ini?
Ano ini?
Low. Low. Nababatayan guys?
Yes, sir.
Oh. Nambot na ano? Na... Okay na. Sorry. Hindi ko naman malaya na kukuha ngayon. Na... Maihan na mag-gamit-gamit Google Meet. Anyway, so for number 2, both statements are correct, tapos letter A yung ating sagot. Now, for number 3, ano yung sabi sa number 3? Sabi niya dito, the accounting cycle involves 9 required steps plus 1 that is considered optional at the beginning of every accounting period. The processes or steps are as follows. So, binigyan tayo dyan, guys. Binigyan tayo dyan, guys, ng 10 steps. So, all in all, guys, yung accounting cycle natin is 9 plus 1. Hindi ko sinasabi, guys, na 10. 9 plus 1. Kay sir, kay 10 man ito. Kaino diri yan, 9 plus 1. Kaino diri 10. Basta guys, you will understand bakit 9 plus 1 ang pinupush ko, hindi 10. Kay sir, 9 plus 1, 10 man yan. Nga ni, 10. 9 plus 1 is 10. Pero aton accounting cycle involves 9 plus 1. Nagigits ako niyo guys. Kaya na sering
yes,
ako
sir.
Nga. Kaya na sering ako nga. Okay, spill that tea. 9 plus 1, guys, kay usually, 10 gaditiya, o garing la, accounting cycle, 9 la talaga, guys, it required. Plus 1, kahit usa optional. Believe it or not, minsan, 11 itiya. Guys, 11. Pero, embedded it usa, between some other steps. Okay? If you can still remember yung basic accounting nyo, di ba gumagawa kayo ng worksheet, yung mga kolumnar-kolumnar, di ba, yung may unadjusted trial balance, tapos may adjustment, adjusted trial balance, tapos may column for income statement, tapos column for balance sheet, ganun. Diba? Iniiyakan nyo pa nga kung nagkakamali kayo dun sa mga totals. Konting mali lang dun, kasi bawal erasure. Ulit ka na naman. Diba? Ang sarap. Ang saya ng basic accounting, guys. Diba? Ang saya. Yan. So, yung iba doon, yung worksheet na yon actually, part na yon ng... Sige, mamaya na. Mamaya na natin yan. Yan. Ah, sige. Yung question dito, actually, guys, sa statement, sa number 3, tinatanong lang the correct order. Yung correct order natin. So, we have 4 choices. Based on how you remember yung basic accounting nyo, yung accounting processes, we have, sabihin na lang natin, complete 10. Kasi 9 plus 1, that would be 10. Ano ang correct sagot natin sa pagkasunod-sunod? First, at first glance, guys, sunod-sunod ba? Is it ano chronological, yung nakalagay dito? Yes or no? Chronological ba siya? Yes or no? No. Yun, minagsagot ng no. So that's correct. Hindi siya no. Hindi siya chronological. Bakit hindi siya chronological? Sige, isa-isahin natin. Number one, sa number one, nagre-refer siya ng identifying and analyzing business transaction. Is it correct? Yan yung number one, guys. Yes. Okay? So, when we analyze business when we do accounting process, dapat unahin muna natin, guys, yung ano, identifying. So, when we identify, ano yung sinasabi nating identify and analyze business transaction? Yung in relation kanina sa statement 1 and item 1 and item 2, yung tinatawag natin na mga accountable events. Kasi dun lang natin i-consider kung yung isang item is, yung isang transaction can be entered into the accounting records. Okay? So, lagay ko lang dito. Steps sa ilalagay ko dito sa notes yung sunod-sunod. So we'll have first identifying and analyzing. Tawag nun, business transactions. Yan yung number one. Next. Ano yung pangalawa? Kasi sabi nyo, at first glance, hindi siya chronological. First is identifying. How about yung next? Okay. So, meron nang nagsagot. After identifying and analyzing business transactions, i-enter na natin siya sa record. So, when we enter it into the record, yung tawag sa process na yon is what? Journalizing.
Analyzing, sir.
Yun. Sana yun. Journalizing. Or recording in the journals. Okay? Recording in the journals. Can you remember ano yung tawag natin sa journals? May other term for journal, guys. Naalala nyo? Kasi di ba dalawa yan, journal at saka ledger. Merong tawag sa kanila eh. Ano ang tawag sa journal?
Books of original entry, sir.
Oh, yun. Correct. Books of original. Original entry. Yan. So, okay na. Next. Ano yung next? After journalizing or recording in the journal, ano yung sunod? Sana yun. Wait lang, tignan ko yung codex ko. May handout takdi di guys. Kanan review. Ano ni? Ledger. Yan. So that would be posting to ledger accounts or posting to the ledgers. So next step natin is posting to the ledgers. Yan. So ano naman guys yung ledgers? Posting to the ledgers, posting to ledger accounts, yan. Ano yung ledger? Kasi yung journal is book of original entry. What about ledgers? Uy. Ano yung ledger? Alalahanin nyo. Ala, hindi na nila naalala si ledger. Kung babae si ledger, guys, naubahiya kayong kalimtan ninyo. Babae da yun, sir. Balit. So, si ledger, guys, books of what? Sayrin, hindi ti account. Okay. Hindi ti account. Hindi ko na sinasabing mali si ti account totally. Pero, yung tawag sa ledger, guys, is, book of what? Hindi book of accounts, Miss Paris. Kasi yung book of account, guys, ano yan? Ano yan? Chart of accounts, guys, yung book of accounts. Oy, hindi na nila naaalala. Sige, spill the tea na lang. Book of final entry. Hala, hira. Uy, diri si kadari entry. Nicole. Hinan niyo basic accounting, so sumat ko kamo. Sir Chavez, ano? Naalala na, guys? Books of final entry. Guys, ayaw ito niyo kangalimti. Ha iyo ba ya table of specification or pointer sa iyo quali? Anakon na kita dito and kanan previous. Dik maaramit next nga quali. Basta previous, may nakabutang dito na terminologies. So, kailangan maram ka mo terminologies. Ito na natira ako na tawag journal. A journal, books of original entry ton. Tapos, ledgers, book of final entry. Yung sinasabi kanina ni Miss Cyril na T-account is just a visual representation ng ledger. Kasi yung ginagawa kasi natin, di ba, sa basic accounting, yung T-account, yan yung pinaka parang ang tawag nga doon is, tawag to parang backbone? Backbone ba yun? Hindi ko na. Basta yung tawag doon is just a mere visual representation ng ledger. Di ba yung T-account? Ganito yung itsura ng T-account. Wait lang guys ah. Mag-exhibition. Sana yun. T-account. Ganito yan. Yan. T-account. Tapos, meron siyang ganyan. Ganito na lang. Ganito kasi yung nakasanayan kong itsura ng T-account. Literal guys na cross. Yan. Yan yung T-account. So, ito yung tinatawag nating T-account. Yung entirety na ito, hindi yan ang tawag ledger. Nako-confuse yan ng mga students. T-account is not a ledger itself, but it is a visual representation lang ng ledger. Pero nowadays, parang acceptable na siya na notion na pag T-account ledger.
Wala ka audio, sir.
Wala ka audio na liwat? Hello? May audio?
Yes, sir.
May da na po, sir.
Ay, sorry. Sorry lang, guys, ha. Hain ang kanto, guys. Di na ako na utod. Ay, waray, may nanong dumalaking niya kan. Ayun, cross. Okay. So, yung ulitin ko lang ha. Yung T-account, okay? Yung notion, pag T-account, ledger. Partly correct, partly hindi. Okay? Kasi when we say ledger, book of final entry yan. Tama naman na T-account related sa ledger. Pero pag sinabi kasi nating T-account, visual, take note ha, yung term ko, visual representation lang siya ng ledger. Hindi siya equivalent immediately sa ledger, although visual representation siya. Okay? So, when we make T-account, pag nag-enter ka ng amount dito sa side na to, dito, yan, naka-highlight, nakikita ba yung highlight? It is said what? Ano yung ini-imply pag naglagay tayo sa ilagyan ko na nga lang ng dito left tas dito right. When we put an amount on the left side of the T account, ano dyan? The account is said to be what? Yun. Correct. Debit. Debited. Very good. How about to the right? Credit. Yun. Credit. The account is said to have credited. Okay? So I hope naaalala ha. Naaalala 'yon. And please, please lang. Please. Pag sinabi nating ledger, wag agad sabihing T account. Hindi naman siya mali, hindi rin siya tama. Parang in between. Okay? Pero kung wala sa choices yung ano, yung book of final entry, pwede nating sabihin related to T account, ganon. Pwedeng ganon. Or T account is related to ledger. Pero pag tinanong kayo, ledger is commonly known as hindi T account. Book of final entry. Nakakita na kamo guys in ledger? Journal ng ledger, nakakita na kamo? Yun. Yes, sir. Kagin require kami ni Sir Chavez nga ni Sir Malkis to hold to. Actually, guys, pwede ka mo ito makapalit ha mga bookstores. May deton. And mga businesses, mga small businesses, gini-encourage itong hirap pag double entry. Para sir kagamit. Okay na ito. Pero guys, kung ako niyo naging basic accounting, magagamit ang ledger nga ng journal. Especially journal. Kaya it journal kasi guys, may dalot niya journal sheet. And pwede la guys, di ba nga niya mapiksi? May dalot niya journal book. As in, kon talaga, libro talaga hiya. May da iton. Oo. Sige la. Good thing nga diri ako niyo naging teacher. Kaya kung ako, bangin diri natatapos ang semester, bangin tapos na ang semester, ledgers lagap kita. Para kita makatapusan, accounting cycle. Anyway. O sige na, nag-i-enjoy na kamo. Ano't sunod? Ano't sunod? Ano't sunod? O yun. Preparing what? Preparing. Okay. Sunod, guys. Preparing trial balance. Ano, guys, itinutukoy din, guys, nga trial balance. Ayun. Very good. Ayan. So, naalala pa man ngayon. Unadjusted. Unadjusted. Kaya ano guys, kaya napagsiring ko kung ano yung klase ng trial balance. Yan. Kaya guys, ambot ko nakakita ka muhad to dati ang video nga ni Facebook. Pero undergrad na iabot na kadto nga video. Mga ako nakalad to, fifth year na da. Nagtitinuok ya guys, at istorya anay, sideline na kita, a segue. Nagtitinuok ya guys, kay, syempre, basic accounting, na accounting process, ada na her preparation, or preparing trial balance. Ngayon guys, wari ka na makaget sa video, ngayon, ang pinapahimo nga trial balance after hand posting to the ledger, which means unadjusted. Diba? Ano't iyo expectation pag ng trial balance? Ano't dapat may adaha debit and credit? Ano dapat tira?
Balance.
Trial balance nga lagi, sir. So, dapat equal. Kung magkano ang debits, nga ganun din ang credit. Saan yan, guys, nakukuha natin yung concept na ganun, na dapat equal ang debits and credit? Saan yan nagsisimula? Pag tinanong kayo, saan nagsisimula? When, ato, Mahirap mag-English. Saan nagsimula yung concept na dapat yung debits equal sa credits? Based on the first four natin na transactions. Yun. Very good. Accounting equation. And based on our, ito yung number three, yung first four na to, yan, yung identifying, journalizing, tapos posting, nagsisimula ang concept ng ating balancing ng trial balance, yung debits and credits, dyan po sa journalizing din. Aside from the basic accounting equation. Okay, kasi given yan, yung basic accounting equation. Pero, pwede na natin i-relate sa journalizing. Why? Di ba nga, pag nag-debit tayo ng amount, yung corresponding credit should equal the amount debited, amounts debited. Hindi na ba ibig sabihin na isang credit lang equal na dun dapat sa debit? Isang debit dapat equal yung amount na dapat nating i-credit agad in one entry of credit. We can have multiple debits tapos single credit, or we have multiple debits and multiple credits, or pwedeng single debit and credit. As long as at the end of the record, equal. Ganon din sa trial balance. Doon nakuha yung concept na kailangan balance siya. Balik tayo dun sa video. Alam nyo guys, yung student, panay ng iyak. Kasi hindi daw nag-balance yung kanyang trial balance. So anong ginawa ng student? Alam ko, ginawa nyo rin yan. Diba? Ano yung technique? Kasi yung alam nyo dapat equal. Anong gagawin pag hindi nag-equal? Yung pinagbabawal na technique. Anong tawag doon? Nangatawa, hira. Force balance. Guys, diri kita pwede mag-force balance. Pwede pa undergrad. Pero kung CPA ka na, guys, diri pwede ha. Mag-CPA ka nga, hindi ka pwede, guys, mag... Hindi ka pwede mag-force balance kay guys, mapipriso ka. Hindi rin pwede, guys, ha? Ay ka mo pag-force balance. Okay. So, again, sa ano, guys... Sa preparing trial balance, yung unadjusted, of course, yung main goal natin is dapat trial balance nga eh. Kailangan mag-equal. But by name itself, trial balance, kapag unadjusted, acceptable pa guys on our part dapat na hindi siya magbabalance. Okay pa yun kung hindi pa magbalance sa unadjusted. Kasi ano yung sunod ng preparing trial balance, ng unadjusted trial balance? Ano yung sunod? Okay, yung iniiyakan natin. Kayo talaga. 'Di ba? Yung iniiyakan natin, sir, real talk ka man. Adjusting entries. 'Di ba? Damot nagtutukin eh. Ng adjusting entries, ambot ano? Pero guys, wala tawarik ng tuok. Naigbos. Naigbos na katamang to kanto. Diba? Adjusting entries. Now, adjusting entries, guys. Adjusting entries. Adjusting entries. Damo ito, guys, kalain. It adjusting entries. So, I hope may da ka muna nung dumanhan iyo accruals. Accruals of income and expenses. Deferrals and prepayment. Deferrals natun, guys. Duha gay pitiya ka klase. Deferral of income and deferral of expense. Pero, he deferral of expense, ginhimo yung prepayment. Pwede tiya. It prepayment under deferral ito actually. Then, we have yung corrections ng errors. Then, we also have yung provisions. Okay? Marami yan. Okay? In the succeeding items, masusunod-sunod natin, we'll go also with adjusting entries. Then, also sa problem solving. Okay, pupunta din tayo dyan, don't worry. Unahin muna natin to kasi I want you to be refreshed of the concepts. So, yan, adjusting entries. So, okay na. Okay, ano yung sunod ng adjusting entries? Ayan. Sunod na nga, adjusting entries. Wait. Preparing trial balance. Ano nga klase ng trial balance? Kailangan adjusted. Ba? Preparing trial balance adjusted. So, makakaduha ka mo, guys. Actually, paghihimon trial balance, di da pa lang a point. Pero, may da pa itong additional trial balance later. May da pa kamot usa nga trial balance. Okay? Pero, as of that point, duha, unadjusted, then adjusted. O sige, ano dapat expectation naton for adjusted trial balance? Ano dapat it expectation? Ano dapat itong debits and credits? Guys, trial balance. Adjusted trial balance. Ano dapat ang expectations sa debits and credits? Dapat ano? Equal. Yo, very good. Equal. Balance. The same na talaga, era, guys. Why? Kasi guys, sa unadjusted trial balance, acceptable pa kung mag-balance or diri. Okay? Correct. Ensure equal debit credit. Kay pag abot mo't adjusted trial balance, diri lang nga ni gihap guys mag-equal, it's either may mali ka ha adjusting entries, may nakalimutan ka sa adjusting entries, or may mali ka sa posting, or yung worst, may mali ka sa journalizing. Yung tatlong yan, babalikan mo. And on that point, pag hindi nag-equal ang trial balance mo sa adjusted trial balance o yung amount sa adjusted trial balance, pwede ka nang umiyak. Okay? Kasi no more room for error pag adjusted trial balance. Okay? Yung sinabi ko sa inyo, yung video na iniyakan niya, actually hindi pa dapat siya umiyak. Kasi unadjusted pa lang, okay pa yun pag hindi equal ang debits and credits. Pero yung goal natin guys sa trial balance is to ensure lang. Okay? So yung ano natin, yung concept natin for trial balance ha, whether adjusted or unadjusted, trial balance is to ensure or test lang guys sa test the equality of debits and credits. Amula po ito at aton. Okay? So, if we're going to ensure or test the equality of debits and credits, hindi ka po dapat mag-iisip na correct na agad ang record. Okay? Pero guys, pagdating mo sa adjusted trial balance, may sabi na lang natin 99% na correct ka na. Assuming correct ka sa journalizing, posting at saka sa adjusting entries. Okay? Malaki na ang chance na tama ang adjusted trial balance mo. Okay? But whether unadjusted or adjusted, yung goal lang is to test the equality or to ensure the equality of debits and credits. Hindi ibig sabihin na nag-equal ang debits and credits na tama na ang records. Okay? Hindi yun ang purpose ng trial balance. Okay? Bakit hindi? Kasi whether we like it or not, ang accounting is always estimate. And based on those estimates, we try the equality of debits and credits. Okay? Yun palagi ang tandaan ha sa theories. Pag tinanong ka ano yung purpose ng trial balance, whether you are asked with adjusted or unadjusted, ang sagot mo dapat is to test the equality of debits and credits. Okay? Hindi yung accuracy. Hindi siya nag-i-ensure ng accuracy ng records. Okay? Not all records are accurate. Okay? Mag-iba ang precise accurate. I-search nyo na lang. Okay? Nag-gets ako guys doon. Nag-gets ako. Kindly raise hand people. Kindly raise hand dito sa ano. Virtual. Kung nag-gets ako doon. Ayun. Sige. O, ano yung sunod? Ano yung sunod ng adjusted trial balance? Ha? Ayun. Preparing financial statements. O, balikan ko yung tanong ko kanina. Yung advanced question ko kanina dun sa statement 1 ata? Or statement 2 ba yun? Item 1 or item 2? Pang ilang step si preparation of financial statements? Ibilangin nyo. 1, 2, 3, 7. O, ika 7. So, tama ba yung statement natin kanina na accounting cycle does not end in the preparation of financial statements? Tama ba yun? Yes. Okay? Yes na yes. Kaya no yes? Kaya dito pala guys, saan aton question number 3, napulo na niyo ihap. Ikapito pala kita. Alright. O sige. So in the preparation of financial statements, alam nyo na kung ano yung mga financial statements na ginagawa natin. Yung common, lilima po ang common. Lilima. Sasabtan kita guys sa waray-waray. So, we have 5 common financial statements na pre-prepare. But based on accounting standard, yung Philippine Accounting Standard 1 natin or yung International Accounting Standard 1 natin, we have actually more than 5 na financial statement na ginagawa as part of financial report. Yung tinatawag po natin guys na complete set of financial statements, hindi lang po yan 5. Pero yung common on those financial statements sa pre-prepare, 5. Ano yung mga 5 na yun guys? Say, bigyan niyo ako ng mga financial statements na common. Common, commonly, Hello. May audio?
Yes, sir.
All right. Okay. So, ano
yes,
ulit
sir.
Yun? Okay. So, commonly prepared financial statements. So, commonly prepared financial statements. So, commonly prepared financial statement. First, we have statement of financial position, or commonly known as balance sheet. Next is statement of comprehensive income. Okay? Yung nakapaloob po guys sa statement of comprehensive income nyo is profit or loss or income statement. Next, included din sa statement of comprehensive income yung tinatawag na OCI statement. Oh wait, baguhin ko na lang. Other comprehensive income. Okay? Then next we have statement of changes in equity, or kung sa basic accounting we have statement of changes in capital. Then next we have anong isa? Statement of cash flows. Ano yung last na common? Notes to FS. So guys, lima po ang common. Commonly prepared FS. Okay? Yung isa, statement of financial position, or kilala nyo as balance sheet. Yung isa naman is statement of comprehensive income. Yung common po na ginagawa nyo is income statement. Income statement is just a component of statement of comprehensive income. Yung comprehensive income po natin, dalawa po ang component niya na statement. Profit or loss or income statement, then yung isa, the other comprehensive income. Okay? Then next, we have statement of changes in equity. Then last, we have statement of cash flows. Cash flows, dapat may S. May S rems. Statement of cash flows. Alright. Then last, notes to FS. Yan. Ha Philippine Accounting Standards 1 or yung International Accounting Standards 1, meron pa pong additional, yung pinaka-complete set talaga ng financial statements. Okay? So later on, you will know about that. Okay? So yan ha, take note yung commonly prepared FS ha. Yung income statement or profit or loss is just a component of statement of comprehensive income. Take note of that ha, take note. Kindly raise hand kung nagets ako. Alright. So sige, after financial statements, ano yung sunod? Anong sunod? Sana yun. Ayan. Closing. Preparing. Closing. Closing entries. Ano yung kino-close natin ng mga entries? Ano yung kino-close natin ng mga entries? Closing entries are for what? Closing Closing entries are for for what, guys? Yun. Merong nakakorrect. Nominal or temporary. Tinatawag na nominal or temporary. Nominal or temporary accounts. Ano yung tinatawag natin na mga nominal or temporary accounts? We are referring to what? Okay? Income statement. Hello. Ayan. Sige. Ano yung mga nominal account na yun? Income statement accounts. Ano yung mga income statement accounts na yun? Alam na natin yan. Okay? Yung revenues and expenses coming from the regular activities. Then also, we have yung OCI accounts. Okay? OCI accounts. Temporary lang din yan. Why temporary? Kasi ipre-present din natin yung OCI accounts natin to equity. So, hindi mo yan makikita separately in the following year separate accounts. Okay? Embedded yan sa equity. Then last, yung isa yung nakakalimutan minsan is the drawing. Drawing account is common for sole prop and partnership. Okay? Ayan. Mayan ang mga temporary accounts natin. Okay? Nagats ako kay Lee Rayzand. Alright. O, after preparing closing entries, ano yung sunod? Ano yung sunod? Nasaan yung colleagues ko? Ayun. Post. Okay. Post. Closing. Trial. Balance. Post closing trial balance. So, post closing trial balance after preparing closing entries. So, ibig sabihin, guys, ilang trial balance ang gagawin mo in a complete accounting cycle? Very good. Tatlo. The first two trial balances, yung adjusted at saka unadjusted, kasama pa po doon ang nominal or temporary accounts. But for post-closing trial balance, ang usual natin na tinatry for balancing of debits and credits are for what? Usually, it is for permanent. Iti-test mo ang equality ng debits and credits by considering yung permanent accounts na lang. Kasi na-close na yung nominal accounts eh. Saan mako-close ang nominal accounts? Sa equity. Equity is a permanent account. Okay, any equity accounts are permanent accounts. O sige, ano yung sunod? Ano yung last? Ayun. Reversing. Reversing entries. Yung reversing entries, guys, ito po ang optional. Apart from worksheets, yung columnar na sinasabi natin, yung mga worksheets, guys, nandito po siya, embedded po siya dito sa journalizing, posting, trial balance, na unadjusted, tapos hanggang financial statements. So, step 1, step 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, okay, step 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, yun, dun ka po usually gumagawa ng worksheet. Meron ka rin namang ginagawang worksheet for closing entries and post-closing trial balance. Pero, yung ginagawa nyo nung basic accounting nyo, ang alam ko, yung common na pinapagawa sa inyo, worksheets for step 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 until financial statements. Okay? So, optional lang po sa reversing entries. It's up to you if you're going to to prepare reversing entries. Optional siya for the beginning. Take note ha, beginning of the next accounting period. Okay? So, based on our answer for number 3, ano ang sagot? Letter? Ayun, letter C. So, ang sagot natin is letter C if we're going to follow. So, 1, 4, 2, 3, 5, 7, 6, 8, 10, 9. Yun yung proper order. Okay? All right. Ano yung sunod? Ano yung sunod? Next statement, next item. Item 4. O, anong sabi sa item 4? In identifying and analyzing business transactions or events, which of the following is considered highlight accountable? Yung tinatanong dito, for purposes of identifying and analyzing business transactions, asan daw ang accountable? Highlight nyo, accountable. O asan ang accountable dyan? Accountable, accountable. Meaning, ang pwedeng ma-enter sa records. Question, is letter A accountable? Okay. Ang term na ginamit sa letter A is personal. Okay? Personal. When we say accountable, okay, take note ha, number 4, for number 4, when we say accountable transactions or events, we are only referring to what? Kanina, yung term na ginamit, ano yung clue term dapat? Business. Okay? Dapat business. Accountable business transaction. Is letter A a business transaction? Ha? Business transaction ba si letter A? No. Dire po. Very good. What about letter B? Hiring a new employee in the accounting division. Question, business transaction ba yan? Okay. Wait. Anong sabi? Hiring a new employee. How do we compare letter A and letter B? Eto ha. Take note. Be very careful. Be very careful. Baka tanungin kayo eh. Identifying of accountable and non-accountable. Tapos, business and non-business transactions. Si letter A is non-accountable and non-business transaction. Take note ha. Letter A is non-accountable, non-business transaction. But si letter B is a business transaction. Okay? Pwede siyang business transaction siya, business transaction or event, but ang tanong ba, accountable? Kung tatanungin ka kung business transaction siya or hindi, ang sagot, business transaction. Ang sunod na tanong, accountable ba o hindi? Ang sagot nyo, no. Why? Nag-hire ka guys ng employee. It is referring to your business. Bakit siya hindi accountable? So tatanungin mo guys ang sarili mo. Does letter B refers to an event, an accountable a business event that is that affects the assets, liabilities, equity, income and expenses. Correct. Hindi na apektuhan ng basic accounting equation. Correct yan, correct. So kung tatanungin ko kayo, when hiring an employee will affect the basic accounting equations, yung mga elements of financial statements. Sagot na not all. Na not all. Pero ang magiging relative subsequent transaction na makaka-affect sa basic accounting equation is what? In relation to employees, anong makaka-affect sa basic accounting equation natin? O yung elements ng financial statements? Yun. Correct. Salaries and wages. Oh, you're learning. I like that. Nice. Very good. So, pag nag-hire pa lang, guys, wala pa yan, guys, wala pa yung effect sa elements of financial statement. Subsequent pa. Okay? Subsequent pa. Payment of salaries is no longer hiring kasi hired na eh. Pero kung hiring pa lang, wala pa. But hiring an employee is a business transaction and event. But not an accountable business transaction. Ay, may dang answer. Mga non-accountable business transaction ay oo. Maida. It aton malagay differentiation of business transaction is whether it affects the elements of financial statements. Okay? Take note of that. Next, proceed. Letter C. Ano yung ginamit sa letter C? Purchase of ulit. Personal. Accountable or not? Business transaction ba? Yon. Very good. Yon, very good. Very good. Mm-hmm. None. So ano sagot natin? Ah, malamang, sir. Klaro na. Letter D. Why letter D? Letter D, sir, because yung term na sabi doon, purchase of land as factory site. Guys, waray man po personal for personal use na factory site. It naghihimo man lang factory site, mga business. So this one is a business event or transaction that is accountable. Okay? O next. Number 5. Ay, by the way, guys, nagets ako han number 4. Kindly raise hand. Alright. Sige. So, sige, guys. Next, number 5. Number 5, sabi dyan, in identifying and analyzing business transactions. So, identifying and analyzing pa rin. An accountant should determine the accounts affected and the corresponding value to be recorded. Correct. Correct yan. To achieve this, an accountant must gather certain, highlight, certain documents that will serve as the basis for recording transactions. Ang tinatanong, what documents are being referred to? Anong klaseng documents? Okay? Anong naaalala nyo? Anong tawag sa... Ano na yan? Documents. May term dyan. Is letter B referring to... letter B? Letter A referring to a business document? Or a certain document used? Ang sabi dyan kasi is legal documents. Pwede. Pwede. What about letter B? Guys, pag sinabi nating legal documents, we are referring to contracts, agreements. Okay? Put into papers. Okay? Yun yung legal documents. Letter B. Anong sabi sa letter B? Invoices, receipts, and vouchers. Pwede. Pwede ang B. Okay? Pwede ang B. What about letter C? Ang sabi dyan, working papers. Ay, hindi pwede si B. Ay, si C, rather. Hindi pwede si C. Kasi si letter C, referring sa letter C, dun sa sinabi ko kanina na mga worksheets, yung journal mo, columnars, yung ginagawa mo all throughout steps, step 2 to 7, or step 2 to 10, at 2 to 9, worksheet yon, mga worksheet, journal sheets, ganun. Working papers yon. So, bawa, hindi pwede si C. So, hindi certain document na nire-refer. Kasi ang sabi pa lang dito, analyzing and identifying and analyzing transactions or events. Ito hindi, along the way to eh. Okay? So, working papers are prepared after identifying and analyzing. Nasa identifying and analyzing pa lang tayo. So, we are stuck with A, B, and D. Si B, si D, ang sabi sa D is source documents. O, ano sagot natin? Ayun, biglang naalala. Okay? Biglang naalala. Actually, guys, it is a slip of the tongue. Nasabi ko actually kanina, hindi nyo lang napansin. Okay? For number 5, ang sinabi ko kanina na would refer to source documents is business. Business documents. Business documents are equivalent to source documents. Okay? Kasi mga personal documents, hindi yan business documents, hindi yan source documents. Yung tinatawag natin na documents for an na ginagamit na na gagamitin natin for analyzing business transactions and events, yan po ang source documents or business documents. Anong example ng mga source documents or business documents? Anong example niyan? Yung letter A, example din yan. Yung letter B, mas lalo na. Therefore, guys, pwedeng isagot si A and B, pero ang pinaka-proper talaga is source documents. Ang tawag po sa document na nire-refer sa number 5, okay, source documents. Anong example ng source documents? Legal documents, for example, contracts and agreements put into papers, then invoices, receipts, and vouchers. Nahabol ako, guys. Sagot natin ha, number 5, letter D. Kindly raise hand kung nagets ako dun. Alright. Let's move forward. Ayan. So, sa number 6, anong sabi sa number 6? A journal is a book, either electronic or... Wala ata akong audio. Let... Ah, meron. Sabi dito, a journal is a book, either paper or electronic, used to record business transactions. Correct yan. Okay, pag sinabi natin, guys, journal is a book, either paper, pag sinabi natin paper, yung manual na tayo ang magsusulat. Okay? Manual na isusulat. Okay? By hand. Pero pag sinabi natin electronic, itatype. Manual lagyap, sir. Adiri, kikakato mo computer. So, electronic. Okay? Kadiri, sir, kay itatype mo, manual lagyap. Diri nga ni kagool. Joke lang. Okay. Business transactions are recorded as journal entries containing at least a debit and a credit under an accounting system called, ura-ura guys kung magsayo pakitahin eh. Okay? Double entry system of bookkeeping. Okay? Magsayo pa nga ni guys, ambot nga haw. So, sumat ko kamukan kuan. Okay? So, double entry, letter D. Hindi siya, no? Hindi siya self-explanatory naman siya, guys. Okay? Yan. Proceed. Ha, number 6, guys. It's single entry system bookkeeping. It example ito, guys. May dakala cash book. Or may dakala check checkbook or logbook. Amulatiya. Okay, kung nakita ka mo ha mga paimprintahan, ha mga printing business ba guys? Or di nga ni ha mga small convenience stores sa downtown, usually makikita mo latira nga naglalagbook. Okay? Kung piraan na gawas. Like, for example, so ha mga cafeteria. Ha mga cafeteria, makikita ni mo maglalagbook dito nga adi, may nagpalitin another kuan nga sura. So, gadini. So, gadi ni kada mga kanon, amulat yat, single entry. Okay? Cashbook, checkbook, or logbook, amulat yat. Pero pag double entry system, mga bookkeeping, amutot na gamit kat journal, maging di debit, maging credit. Okay? O, sige, number 7. Ayan, agi statement to naliwat ano. Okay, ay layton. Kaya tayo ni. Okay, the recording process, recording na kita guys sa step 2 na. Record out step 3. Out 2 lang ayang gap. 2. Kay recording, journalizing, so step 2. The recording process involves entering business transactions in either of two types of journals. Okay? General journal and special journal. Sana all may special. Eh, the transactions that involve sales, purchases, cash receipts, and cash disbursements are recorded in highlight, ang sabi niya, special journals. Ano daw? Ano daw yung mga transaction na yan? Sales, purchases, cash receipts, and cash disbursements. Statement 1. Correct? Yun. Yes, sir. Yun. Correct. Naalala yung dalawang type of journal. We have general, we have special. Okay? Pag sinabi natin, guys, general journal, those transactions na not necessarily repetitive. Not in bulk, not repetitive. Although ordinary din naman siya. Business event din siya. Referring to business events. For example, bumili ka ng equipment. I-enter mo lang siya. I-enter mo yung pag-purchase mo ng tawag nun, ng equipment, first sa general journal. Pag nagbayad ka, that's a cash disbursement, doon ka na papasok sa special. Yung pagbabayad. Pero if you purchased an equipment through cash immediately back, yung papasok lang sa special journal is the credit side on cash. But the debit side, general journal yan. Okay? Or if both debits and credits cannot be put into special journal, papasok lahat yan sa general journal. Okay? Common transactions na may special journal, ayan, sales, purchases, receipts, and disbursement. Why? Okay? Yan ang common, pero meron pang iba. Why common? Kasi repetitive and in bulk. Pag sinabi nating repetitive and in bulk, mayat maya, guys, may sale, mayat maya, may purchase, mayat maya, may bayad, and collections. Nagets ako sa statement 1 kay Lirisand. Ah, sige. Proceed. Statement 2. The transactions other, take note, yung term is other than. Other than sales, ibig sabihin hindi siya sale, hindi siya purchase, hindi siya cash receipt, hindi siya cash disbursement. Ire-record daw also to special journal. Also recorded in special journal. Correct or incorrect? Guys, correct or incorrect? Statement 2. Transactions daw. Okay, nasabi? Transactions other than. Yung term dyan is other than. Sales, purchases, cash receipts, and cash disbursements are also recorded in special journals. Correct? Incorrect? Okay. Hanging in mid-air. Guys, incorrect. Mali po si statement 2. Bakit? Yung term natin is other than sales, purchases, cash receipts, and cash disbursement. Okay? Pag hindi po pwedeng ipasok sa sales, kung hindi siya purchase, kung hindi siya cash receipt, at kung hindi siya cash disbursement, hindi po siya ipapasok sa special journal. Saan po siya papasok? Ano dapat ang proper term dito? Instead of special, ano dapat? Very good. Okay? Dapat ang proper term. So, statement 1, correct. Then, statement 2, incorrect. Kaino incorrect, guys? Should be general journal. Take note of that, guys, ha. Other than those four na common, the rest, general journal na po. So, sagot natin, statement 1 correct, statement 2 incorrect, letter C. Sagot natin is letter C. Nagets ako? Kindly raise hand kung nagets ako. Alright. Okay. Number 8. Hala, man 9 na. Number 8 pala kita. Sige, Layton. Number 8. So, sagot natin sa number 7 is letter C. Yan. O, number 8. Sabi niya, the transaction should be recorded in the respective journals, like highlight, in their respective journals, in highlight, chronological order, and as they occur. Bakit redundant ano guys? Chronological order and as they occur. Pag sinabi kasi natin guys, chronological order, equivalent na ito guys sa as they occur. Okay? Kay diri liwat sir. Kay waray ka sir, igre-record kung diri mag-occur an event. Ata, maliwat. Sige nala. Okay? So, pag nag-occur, dapat chronological. Statement 1, correct, incorrect. Oh, yun. So, statement 1, correct. O, statement 2, how about statement 2? Statement 2, sabi niya, when recording transactions in the journal, the amounts debited should mathematically be equal. Should mathematically be equal to the amount or amounts credited. Correct, incorrect? Malamang, automatic ito. Automatic ito, yeah. Correct. So, letter A. Okay? Kaya ano, explain tanguti. Okay? Just like what I have said earlier about debits and credits, it does not necessarily mean na pag mag-debit ka ng isa, dapat isa lang din ang i-credit mo. Not necessarily. You can have one debit, multiple credits, multiple debits, one credit, or multiple debits, multiple credits, or both one debit and one credit. Pwede yan. Again, ano ang goal? Mathematically, equal ang debited amount sa credited amount. So, answer, letter A. Okay? So, guys, pwede nyong i-relate ang ating review sa mga questions na tinatanong which of the following statement is true, which of the following statement is false, ganun. Pwede yan. Okay? So, sige. Number 9. Ura-urat number 9 kung marong pa. Number 9. Ano't answer number 9? Kadi-discuss talat natin. Ayun. Okay? Ura-ura pa. Letter A. Okay, letter A. Yan. O sige, number 10. Number 9, sagot natin, book of original entry. Okay, book of original entry. Okay, diri po memo, diri po debits and credits. Okay? O, ayan. Number 10. Okay. Nakabot gan man kita ng 10. Okay. So, next. After recording all business transaction, kulangin S. Dapat business transactions. Okay. Into the journals, all the amounts, both debits and credits, that affects an account shall be summarized in a ledger. So, correct. Statement 1. The ledger can be represented by using a T-account which shows and summarizes all debits and credits to a specific account. Correct? Incorrect? Sabi niya, the ledger can be represented by a T-account. Kadi-discuss ko lang kanina. Okay? Which shows, anong sabi? Shows and summarizes to a specific account, debits and credits. Correct. Okay? So, statement 1 is correct. So, S1, correct. S2, S2. Statement 2. Ledger accounts can be identified into general ledger or subsidiary ledger. Kanina, ang journals, duha ka klase na journals. Ano to na journals? Special journal and general journal. Didili what? Ledger. Tama ba na itong ledger accounts can be identified into general and subsidiary? Yung term is general and subsidiary ledger. Okay. Sir, kaya journal kay special journal, dapat special ledger. Loh, diri. Diri ha. Sumat ko yung kakunan yung teacher. Correct po, it's statement 2. So, it aton po ledger, duha po ito nit iya, klase. General, ngan it term it usa subsidiary. Kaya, journal, it journal, general, and special. Pag ledger, general, and subsidiary. Pag sinabi nating subsidiary, iba tiya guys sa journal. Kaya journal, diri po related hi general ngan special. May slight connection ng guti, kung itong imo debits, ma-refer ha general, tapos it credit ha special. Okay? Which is, pwede, mangyari. Kasi usually naman, pag special, special la. Pag general, general la. Pwede gapito mag-general, tapos may usa special. Pwede gapito. Ha-ledger, diri. Diri to sugad, ha? Nga specific la. Ha-ledger, it general, may dapat niya tinatawag na subsidiary. Okay, sir, anot example it mga accounts na general, both may general ngan may subsidiary ledgers. Actually, tanan nga general ledgers, pwede magkaadahin subsidiary ledgers. Okay, but because of certain focus in accounting, not all general ledgers will have subsidiary ledgers. So take note, all general ledgers can or may have subsidiary. Can or may lang ha, subsidiary ledgers. Ledgers, but not at all times. Not at all times, guys, ha? Yan yung rule natin for number 10. Okay? So, sagot, letter A. Oh, nakalapos. Nakalapos kita, 11. So, sagot nato is letter A for number 10. O, number 11. Subsidiary ledgers can be set up virtually for any general ledgers within entities record. Kadi-discuss ko lang. Correct? Incorrect? Correct? Incorrect? Ada pala guys, so kasusurat ko pala. All general ledgers can or may have subsidiary ledgers. Statement 1 is, S1 is correct. S2, ano yung S2? Subsidiary ledgers are created for those accounts which involves high volume of transactions which limits their use for some accounts. So ibig sabihin guys ng statement 2 in relation to statement 1, all general ledger accounts may have subsidiary ledger accounts. But because of high volume of transactions na could affect a certain account within the records of an entity, not all general ledger accounts will have their own subsidiary. Especially kung itong general ledger account kaya niya ma-identify in detail ang transactions na iginkakada ha general ledger. So all amounts pwede ma-summarize in detail ha general ledger. Pero if need in further details, dyan lang po gumagawa ng subsidiary ledger account. Okay? So merong mga examples later. So ano statement 2 is what? Statement 2 is correct. So sagot natin for number 11 is letter A. Okay? So number 11, correct din ang sagot sa statement 2, so letter A. O number 12. Okay, number 12, ano sa number 12? Statement 1. Oh, number 12. Ano sabi sa number 12? Subsidiary ledgers are used to summarize the transactions of, take note, a specific area affecting the account before, take note ha, a specific area affecting the account before they are finally summarized to the general ledger, or yung other term guys sa general ledger is control account. Okay? Yung main account mo or yung general ledger account mo, ang tawag dyan, control account. Okay? So, anong sagot natin for statement 1? Correct, incorrect? Statement 1 is, okay, sagutan natin. Statement 1 is correct. Ano ang purpose ng, tawag nun, subsidiary ledger? Just like what I have discussed, or what is stated in the, tawag nito, statement 1, okay? Pagkaya ng general ledger, ma-identify or ma-identify in detail or ma-summarize in detail ang transactions, pwedeng general ledger na lang ang meron. But subsidiary ledgers are set up to specific areas na nag-a-affect ng control account. Example sa statement 2, sabi sa statement 2, the subsidiary ledgers of an account, receivable account, will refer to the subsidiary ledgers of an account receivable will refer to the individual customer account to whom the entity made credit sale transactions. Anong ibig sabihin guys ng statement 2 in connection with subsidiary ledgers? Okay. So ganito 'yan for number 12. Okay? Control or general. Okay? Account, meaning yung ledger, is referring to yung accounts receivable per balance sheet. Okay? Yung accounts receivable na makikita mo sa balance sheet, ang tawag dyan is general account or general ledger account or control account. Pero ang sabi dito sa statement 2 na individual customer account, okay, yung accounts receivable account ng mga customers, yan po ang tinatawag na subsidiary. Subsidiary ledger account. Okay? Okay? Example niyan is individual customer AR account. Okay? Basically, guys, si accounts receivable per balance sheet, itim nakikita ha balance sheet ni accounts receivable, kaya gad gihap niya summarize or identify in details an nga tanan nga accounts receivable mo. But in order to aid information presented in your control account, subsidiary ledger for accounts receivable is a must. Why? Because not all accounts receivable, take note, sino nag-basic accounting 1 na iyo, maram ako, nag-basic accounting 1 at iba iyo din. Hi. Okay? Haiyo accounts receivable, not all accounts receivable are good accounts receivable. So, kailangan per customer, may ada ka subsidiary ledger account to identify kung hain ang customer nga mabayaron, hain ang customer nga late nagbabayad, hain ang customer nga diri nagbabayad. Nagigets niyo guys it akon point between general and subsidiary ledger? Kindly raise hand. Okay. So kung maghihimo ka guys in concept map, kung maghihimo kang concept map for general ledger and subsidiary ledger, in general ledger ang mutiat pinakaigbaw. So for example, makakita kahin accounts receivable nga 2,500,000 balance sheet. Mapakiana kay mo self. Ano it breakdown hini nga 2.5? Hirahin or sino-sino ang mga customers na merong accounts receivable si company na nakakam up ng 2.5. So titignan mo sa subsidiary ledgers niya or pupuntahan mo ang notes to financial statements. Titignan mo doon, sino-sino bang mga customer, bakit nag 2.5 million to? Ay, meron siyang 100 customers. Si customer A, ganito ang kanyang accounts receivable. Si customer B, ganito, ganyan, and so on, so forth. Total, 2.5 million. Nagets? Kindly raise hand again? Alright. So, statement 2 natin is also correct. Yan ang example, guys, ng relationship ng general and subsidiary ledger. So, number 12 is letter A. O 13. Okay, sagot natin is letter A. O 13. Ay, salamat din na statement on statement 2. O 13, sabi sa 13, which of the following, okay, take note, which of the following, highlight, please highlight, not true. Not true. And, ibig sabihin, ano yung hinahanap? Ibig sabihin, ang hinahanap natin is false or incorrect statement. Okay? So, anong sabi? Which of the following is not true about preparation of trial balance? Okay? Letter A. Ang sabi sa letter A, a trial balance is prepared to test the equality of debits and credits. Sabi daw, to test the equality of debits and credits. Ano yung naalala nyo kanina sa ano natin discussion? Ano yung si letter A? True or not? True or false? True. Ganyan, correct. True. Very good. So, okay si letter A. Hindi natin isasagot si letter A kasi si letter A, true. O, punta kay letter B. All information used to prepare the trial balance are extracted from the ledgers. From the ledgers daw. True or false? Yun. True gihapon. True. So, hindi natin isasagot si letter B. Okay? Hindi rin natin isasagot si letter B kasi true. Kasi not true ang sabi niya nahanap. O next. When a trial balance is prepared, the total debits and total credits should, ang sabi niya, should always be equal even before considering adjustments. True or false? Pwedeng false. Pwedeng false. Pwedeng false. O, sige, punta muna tayo kay letter D kasi may letter D pa. Letter D, a trial balance. Ang sabi niya, a trial balance should not be used to determine the accuracy. Should not be used to determine the accuracy of accounting records as errors may exist. Okay? Ibig sabihin, pwede pa rin daw magkaroon ng error despite may equality ng debits and credits. Is letter D true or false? True or false, letter D? Balikan lang yung sinabi ko kanina about trial balance. Test of equality, not determine accuracy. Okay? So, ibig sabihin, ang sagot natin for number 13 is letter C. Okay? Letter C. Kuha? Sige. So, take note ha. Take note. Tignan nyo guys kung paano ko sagutan yung questions ha. Makakakuha kayo ng technique dyan. Okay? 14. Number 14, ang sabi sa number 14. By the way guys, yung ginagawa kong technique, iniisa-isa ko talaga. Kina-qualify ko each of the choices. Okay? Pero guys, kailangan mabilisan kasi time-bounded kayo sa exam. Okay, 3 hours lang. 3 hours lang exam. Sige, number 14. Sabi sa number 14, which of the following highlight ulit is not false? Is not false. O anong hinahanap? O kung not false, di true ang hinahanap. O ibig sabihin sa number 14, true ang hahanapin na statement. Ang sabi niya, highlight ulit, preparation of adjusted, take note, adjusted trial balance. Okay? Ano na? Kaya pa guys, kaya pa? Kailarisan kung kaya pa. Sige. Paabuton natin hin 20. Kung diri kaya up to 20, will end kung ngayon lang kita mag-stop. Mali. Mag-stop kita kung ngayon kita nag-end. Nabalikan din. Sorry. Sige. Number 14. Yung tinang hinahanap sa number 14 is true about adjusted trial balance. So, focus ka lang sa adjusted trial balance. Okay. Number 14. Letter A. It is prepared before considering all adjustments. Sabi niya, before. Tapos ang tinatanong is about adjusted trial balance. Letter A, true or false? False. Bakit false? Kasi dapat, ano ang dapat nakalagay? After. Uy, may nagsagot ng true. Guys, ang tinatanong natin is adjusted trial balance. Adjusted trial balance. Ibig sabihin, not false. Ibig sabihin, ang tahanapin is true. So, kung true ang hahanapin, letter A, sabi niya, before all adjustments. adjusted trial balance dapat after. So, A is false. So, hindi yan ang sagot kasi A is false. Next. Letter B. It is prepared to test the equality of debits and credits after considering all adjustments and before. Sabi niya, after considering all adjustments and before FS preparation. True or false? Okay. Sabi niya dito, trial adjusted trial balance after considering all adjustment. Ito ang tama, letter A is mali. Kasi dito before, dito after, so correct. Pero mayroong isa sa pang before. Before preparing financial statement. Correct ba to? Yes, sir. Correct yan. Why correct? Kay before kamangkada ng financial statements, adjusted trial balance anay. Okay? So, pwede na sa letter B. Opposite tayo sa letter C. It is prepared without. Sus, ayaw na. Kay dapat may adjustments. Okay? Mas malamang, hey, letter D, di gap sagot. All of the above kuno are not false. So, ibig sabihin daw, A, B, and C, puro true. Hala, diri. So, it's sagot na to. Number 14 is letter. Number 14 is letter what? Letter C. 15. Sabi sa number 15, which of the following will not require adjusting entries? Which of the following, highlight, will not require adjusting entries? Hindi daw magre-require ng adjusting entries. Letter A. A collection of notes receivable was entered as credit to accounts payable. Magre-require ba, guys? Yes or no? Letter A. Ma-require? Will letter A require adjusting entries? Nag-collection ka ng notes pero yung A yung credit mo payable, accounts payable. Magre-require, yes or no? So letter A will require. So hindi natin Hello. Hello. Okay? So si letter A will require adjusting entries. Bakit magre-require? Kasi error on recording. Okay? Letter B. Anong sabi sa letter B? A customer's account was proven worthless after considering all efforts of collection. A customer's account was proven worthless after considering all efforts of collection. Magre-require? Will it require adjustment? Ibig sabihin, na-determine mo na hindi na daw magbabayad ang customer. Pero receivable pa rin ang nakalagay. Mag-a-adjust ka? Okay. Yes. Okay. Sa isahin natin ha. Number 11, number 15, letter A is referring to what? Letter A is referring to error on recording. So magre-require yan ng adjusting entry. Si letter B is provision of bad debt or write-off. Provision of bad debt or write-off. Okay? Magre-require din yan, guys. Okay? Next, letter C. Anong sabi sa letter C? The insurance paid in advance. Take note, ha? Sa letter B, yung clue term natin was proven worthless. Sa letter C, insurance paid in advance. Take note, ha? Paid in advance. Covering 5-year non-life insurance was recorded as outright expense. Outright expense. Okay? Naalala pa, guys, ang adjusting entries? Anong klaseng adjustment to? Paid in advance. Ibig sabihin, prepayment. Ano ang accounting natin for prepayment? Dalawa yan ang pwede. Ano yung isa? Give me one method for accounting for prepayments. Letter C is prepayment of expense. Sa prepayment of expense, dalawa ang pwede. Ano yung isa? Uy, guys. Lana. Nakalimutan nyo na talaga yung adjusting entries, no? Hindi. Yung tinatanong ko is the record. Is the method of recording. Di ba dalawa yun? Dalawa. Sa prepayment of expense. Ano yung dalawang method? Sige. Magbibigay ako ng isa. First is we have asset method. What about the other? Hindi cash and accrual. Asset and what? Yun. Very good. Expense method. O sige. I hope naalala na ha. Expense method and asset method. O kung tatanungin ko kayo, anong method ang ginamit sa letter C? Expense or asset method? Last item na natin to, guys, for today. Expense or asset method? Alright. Expense. Ano ang reason bakit expense method? Ano ang clue bakit expense method? Sabi niya, oh, the insurance paid in advance covering 5-year non-life insurance was recorded all, pagod, all, as outright expense for the year. Ano yung term na ginamit? Very good. Outright expense. Ibig sabihin, expense method yan. So, sagot natin, guys. Anong sagot natin? Letter D. Letter D will not require adjustment. No adjustments. Bakit? Bakit no adjustments sa letter D? For reason na, letter D is just a normal transaction. Okay? Normal transaction lang po si letter D. Sabi niya, the inventory purchased on account, sabi niya, purchased on account, FOB shipping point, was entered in the records for the current year as purchase, despite the inventories are still in transit. Ano naaalala nyo sa merchandising nyo? Diba yung periodic and perpetual? Meron tinatawag doon na FOB shipping point, FOB destination. Pag FOB shipping point, automatic, si buyer po ang may-ari ng goods purchased. Sabi dito, the inventory purchased. Ibig sabihin, ang entity ang nag-purchased, entity ang buyer, FOB shipping point, siya ang liable sa shipment cost, siya na rin ang owner ng goods. So, tama lang na in-enter niya sa records for the current year. So, letter D, no adjustment. So, correct sa letter D. Will not require adjusting entries. Okay? So, we'll end lang muna up to this point. We'll continue na lang for the next session na available kayong lahat. Okay?